friends. Well, we are in part two of the Paradise of the Kingdom. Now, if you have followed me, you will know a little bit more about paradise. Now, as I talked about last time, about that first part of the Paradise of the Kingdom, we understood that paradise is tied to the Tree of Life. And this Tree of Life will be in the New Jerusalem. So we have to talk about the New Jerusalem and exactly the characteristics of it, because we know that it's going to be descending from heaven. Now, this New Jerusalem is in heaven now, being prepared a place. In fact, a verse that I was looking at related to this is in Hebrews 12:22, and it says, "But you have come to Mount Zion and to the city of the living God, the heavenly Jerusalem, to an innumerable company of angels." Okay, so there is a heavenly Jerusalem now. It is part of where paradise is. It is part of that city that is going to be descending from heaven. Okay, so we know that the city comes down out of heaven because we see this in Revelation chapter 21. And we see there in verse 2, "Then I, John, saw the holy city, New Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband." Okay, now there is a lot of tie between the church, the bride of Christ, and the New Jerusalem, because that is where our dwelling place will be. And during the millennial kingdom, we won't be on the earth in our dwelling. We will be interacting on the earth, but we will be dwelling in whatever way we do in the New Jerusalem. And this is the city that actually descends all the way to the earth when the earth is purged by fire. Again, go back and look at the five worlds to understand more there. And when the earth is purged, the New Jerusalem will touch down on the earth and will be the place in the new earth that is renovated completely, because the foundations of the earth never go away. We know that Jesus Christ is the one that holds everything together. In fact, I talked about Jesus Christ, the one you must worship, and you should go look at that. And I referred to places like Colossians chapter 1, where everything consists by Jesus Christ. So he is the one that holds it all together. And when he releases some of that control, if you will, over the creation, we know that it will burn and be purged by fire. But we who are protected by him at that point, and every other person who comes through the kingdom after the great white throne, will somehow be protected in some bubble of sorts while the purging of the heavens and earth happens. And then that city where we dwell will no longer hover over the Jerusalem on earth. It will become the new Jerusalem. So let's look at some of the detail of this city. Now, the city is pretty amazing. And again, it's tied to the bride of Christ as we looked at that verse. And we even see that God is going to make all things new. And it starts off in chapter 21 talking about the new heaven and new earth. But of course, it refers to this city, which we know we will have a part of during the kingdom. So the paradise of the kingdom will be above the kingdom right during that 1,000-year reign, but interacting with the earth, and then it will be on the earth at the end of the millennial kingdom. So that's just a little bit of difference from being in the kingdom that you get when you pay attention to what I'm saying here. Okay, so let's focus on the detail of this new Jerusalem. Now, one of the seven angels, verse 9, it says, one of the seven angels who had the seven bowls filled with the seven last plagues came to me and talked with me, saying, "Come, I will show you the bride, the Lamb's wife." Okay, so the angel is revealing to John the bride. Now look at what it says in verse 10. "And he carried me away in the spirit to a great and high mountain and showed me the great city, the holy Jerusalem, descending out of heaven from God." Okay, so this is the new Jerusalem coming down from heaven, and it is filled with the glory of God. Now, we've got to go on, and I'm just going to read here verse by verse with some of the details, with some possible commentary in between. So, verse 11 here of chapter 21 says, "Having the glory of God, her light was like a most precious stone, like a jasper stone, clear as crystal." So this is God's glory that he, in fact, there's not going to be any need for sun. Oh, I've got a list of things I tell you what, I think I'll stop now and actually give you this list, and then we can remember it as we get to these scriptures, more of these scriptures. Now, again, I am utilizing the information that is given and put together in this book, Charting the End Times, in a lot of what I have talked about in the prophecy series to help give you the understanding better and conceptualizing exactly what all these things are about. So they give a really good description of all of the information about the New Jerusalem from this chapter, that especially, and it gives us this description that they bullet point here on page 127 of this book. So I'm going to read those and give you the references, and you might go back and study that, and then we'll read some of those scriptures as we go through it again. It says, first, there is no longer any sea, and that's verse 1. Again, we're in chapter 21 of Revelation. Secondly, all things will have been made new. Again, verse 1. God the Father will dwell among his people. Verse 3. No longer any death, crying, or pain. Verse 4. All believers will inherit the blessings of the New Jerusalem. Verse 7. The New Jerusalem will have a brilliance like a very costly stone, as clear as jasper. Verse 11. The city has a great and high wall with 12 gates guarded by an angel at each one. Verse 12. The names of the 12 tribes of Israel will appear on the gates. Again, verse 12. There are 3 gates on each of the 4 sides of the city. Verse 13. The wall of the city has 12 foundation stones, and on them are the names of the 12 apostles of the Lamb. Verse 14. The city is a cube measuring 1,500 miles wide, 1,500 miles long, and 1,500 miles high. And that is verses 15 to 17, possibly a mountain. The wall is made out of jasper, verse 18. The city will be pure gold like clear glass, verse 18. The foundation stones of the city wall are made from the following precious stones: jasper, sapphire, chalcedony, emerald, sardonyx, sardius, chrysolite, beryl, topaz, chrysoprase, jacinth, and amethyst. And that's verse 19 and 20. And then the 12 gates are 12 pearls. Each one of the gates is a single pearl. Verse 21. There is no temple in the city, for the Lord God, the Almighty, and the Lamb are its temple. Verse 22. Now remember, there is a temple that is going to be in the millennial kingdom in the Jerusalem there. But in the New Jerusalem, there won't be the need of a temple. That'll be where Christ resides, and we reside with him as he is ruling over the earth at that time, more closely tied to it, and we interact with it. And so that will eventually come down to the new earth, where there will be no temple in the new earth. And then there's no sun or moon, for the glory of God will illumine the city, and its lamp is the Lamb. Verse 23. And the nations will walk by the light of God's glory. Verse 24. The kings of the earth will bring their glory into the city. Verse 24. No longer any night, only day. Verse 25. No longer any unclean, nor anyone who practices abomination and lying. Verse 27. The river of the water of life, clear as crystal, will come from the throne of God and of the Lamb in the middle of the city street. That's chapter 22, verses 1 and 2. On either side of the river will stand the tree of life, bearing 12 kinds of fruits, yielding its fruit every month, and the leaves of the tree will be for the healing of the nations. Verse 2 of chapter 22. No longer any curse. Verse 3 of chapter 22. The throne of God and of the Lamb shall be in the city. Verse 3 of chapter 22. Believers are now able to see the Father's face, and his name will be on their foreheads. Verse 4 of chapter 22. And no longer any sun, because the Lord God will illumine the city, and the people will reign forever and ever. Verse 5 of chapter 22. So, they just say here, what a great and glorious future awaits all believers in Christ. And indeed it does. And during the kingdom, we will have this paradise that we reside in, but we will not be dwelling on the earth per se until it's the new earth that will be where this new Jerusalem finally sets down. And if you look at it, now I have looked at this, it is a cube. Maybe Star Trek got their idea of the Borg from the Bible because of the cube being the place that they were in. But this city is amazing and far better than anything like that. But as we look at some more of the glory in the city, we look at verse 12 of chapter 21, and it says, she had a great and high wall with 12 gates and 12 angels at the gates and names written on them, which are the names of the 12 tribes of the children of Israel. Okay, and then we have further information about those gates. Verse 13 says, three gates on the east, three gates on the north, three gates on the south, and three gates on the west. So you have the gates. And we know later that pearls are a part of this gate and the look of it. But we see in verse 14, now the wall of the city had 12 foundations, and on them were the names of the 12 apostles of the Lamb. So you still have some particular aspect of the apostles being part of this city, as they are the foundation of the church. And were who God had particularly worked with when Jesus had them as his disciples and they became the apostles, either John Mark or maybe Paul being that 12th one, we don't know and aren't told here. But verse 15 here says, and he who talked with me had a gold reed to measure the city, its gates, and its walls. And so we know that the measurement is given, and it is given here in cubits or furlongs are given. And basically, as is mentioned, that translates into about 1,500 square miles. So you think about 1,500 miles, that is a big place. In fact, how many miles was it that Jeff Bezos just went up into the atmosphere where he was weightless for a time, and the passengers with him. Was it like 66 miles or something? This city is going to be 1,500 miles high, 1,500 miles wide. It is going to be able to encompass all people who have believed in Christ very easily. How it's structured, we don't know. We know the outside more than the inside, and we are given more detail here than the measurement that's there. So let's skip down from some of those particular verses and just get to the stones again in verse 19. The foundations of the wall of the city were adorned with all kinds of precious stones. The first foundation was jasper, the second sapphire, the third chalcedony, the fourth emerald. Now, all these stones, we mentioned before, but we'll just read these verses again. Verse 20, the fifth sardonyx, the sixth sardius, the seventh chrysolite, the eighth beryl, the ninth topaz, the tenth chrysoprase, the 11th jacinth, and the 12th amethyst. And so you have all these beautiful gems and stones that are going to be a part of the foundation of this city. That's why many pictures of the New Jerusalem have that rainbow type color, or many different colors that light would come off of these different gems and stones that are going to be a part of this city. And verse 21 says the 12 gates were 12 pearls. Each individual gate was of one pearl, and the street of the city was pure gold, like transparent glass. So you ever hear of the pearly gates? Well, this comes from this idea of the city's gates being pearl. And that will be the color and look of them as this new Jerusalem, this paradise of God, this place where God will dwell, and we who know him will dwell with him. And there's much more we could look at as to the glory of the New Jerusalem as we look at the rest of chapter 21 and even the part in chapter 22. But we know that this is going to be the paradise that was intended for man. Now, man was in paradise in the garden. Man has lived in paradise in a body that's more spiritual when a person who believes in Christ dies. But that place that we can help build by what we do for the Lord is being prepared now and part of this city that will be coming down. You may have heard you can't take it with you. You don't have people who die in their, well, some Egyptian people and maybe some others put wealth and possessions in coffins and things. But you may have heard that you don't have a hearse. You don't have a U-Haul following a hearse. And it just doesn't, because you can't take this stuff with you. Oh, friend, it's all going to burn, Peter says, and so don't be materialistic, but use what God gives you and know that in the future you will have great blessing, and it'll be part of what you even send spiritually up to be a part of what is being built and prepared by the Lord for you. So this is the paradise of the kingdom. And it took two parts just to explain exactly this paradise, this place that God intended for man to be in creation, but man sinned and had to be taken out. And paradise had to be protected through all of this time, and will come back down to the earth, and redeemed mankind will be in this paradise of the kingdom, and the kingdom will last forever, as we will look at that in the next video with the perpetuity of the kingdom. So, like this video, share it with others, subscribe to my channel, and hit the notification bell to be ready for the next video. Thank you for watching.